This is a very low-key book talk video, nothing like you see on the YouTubes. As you can see, my plushy stuffed cat is back there just staring at the screen, so just try to ignore that and all of this. Children's fiction is the most important fiction of all. A direct quote from Neil Gaiman himself. Hello, fellow classmates. The book I chose for my book talk is The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman. So you guys can see the cover there. This book is about an orphan child named Nobody Owens, also known as Bod, is raised by Ghost and his guardian. As he grows up, the boy learns lessons about life and desperately tries to discover more about the world beyond the graveyard that is his home. It is unsafe for him to leave the graveyard, for there is the man who murdered his family and failed to murder Bod is still out there. Searching for the boy to get the job done. Will Bod ever have the chance to live a normal life he so dreams of? So I bookmarked a short passage here to read to all of you. And my bookmark is actually From the Raven by Edgar Allan Poe. Very festive for the themes of this book. Something said, we are the Sleer. The hairs on the back of Bod's neck began to prickle. The voice in his head was something very old and very dry, like the scraping of a dead twig against the window of the chapel, and it seemed to Bod that there was more than one voice there, that they were talking in unison. Did you hear that? He asked Scarlet. I didn't hear anything, just a slithering noise. It made me feel strange, all prickly in my tummy, like something horrible is going to happen. Nothing horrible is going to happen, said Bod. Then to the chamber he said, what are you? We are the Sleer. We guard and we protect. What do you protect? The resting place of the master. This is the holiest of all holy places, and it is guarded by the Sleer. You can't touch us, said Bod. All you can do is scare. The twinning voices sounded petulant. Fear is a weapon of the Sleer. Bod looked down at the ledge. Are those the treasures of your master? An old brooch, a cup, and a little stone knife? They don't look like much. The Sleer guards the treasures, the brooch, the goblet, the knife. We guard them for the master. When he returns, it comes back. It always comes back. How many of you are there? But the Sleer said nothing. The inside of Bod's head felt as if it were filled with cobwebs, and he shook it, trying to clear it. Then he squeezed Scarlet's hand. We should go, he said. I found a review from New York Times, and it says, while The Graveyard Book will entertain people of all ages, it's especially a tale for children. Children will appreciate Bod's occasional mistakes and bad manners, and relish his good acts and eventual great ones. The story's language and humor are sophisticated, but Gaiman respects his readers and trusts them to understand. This novel is for ages 9 and up, but anyone of any age can find something to like, love, or enjoy from this story. I recommend this book to anyone who simply loves ghost stories, who's a fan of Neil Gaiman. You can be of any age and find something to love in this book, something to connect to, gain more insight. I 10 out of 10 recommend this book. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. Final thoughts on this book. Overall, I absolutely loved it. I've always been a fan of the darker themed books with ghosts, the supernatural, these chilling adventures. It's always intrigued me, and I never lost interest at any point in time in this book. It's a huge page turner. As soon as I finished it, I just sat there and I was like, that's it. Like, I was craving and wanting more. I want to know more about these characters. What happens to them? I have so many questions of these certain characters in different places, and just more questions about the world building. I just grew so curious and I dove right into the story. It made me think more about my childhood and how I live my life now. I kept comparing myself to different characters throughout the book, especially with the main character Bod, as he grows up and the different ways that he thinks and that he sees the world, or that he sees the people he loves, the ones who are around him, it just made me reflect on myself a lot. And I started thinking, what does it really mean to be alive, to be human, to live your life to the fullest? And you're not just surviving, you're not just passing time as it goes along. I need more. I just had to let you guys know one of these reviews that says on the back of the book, it's from the Washington Post. They said, it's like a bite of dark Halloween chocolate. This novel proves rich, bittersweet, and very satisfying. This review actually may be one of my favorite reviews of any book of all time. It's pretty creative. I'm very invested in this story, if you guys can't tell yet. This has been my book talk for The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman. I hope all of you enjoyed it.